tell us, when will these things be, and what will be the sign of your coming and of the end of the age?
And it shall come to pass in the last days, saith God, I will pour out of my Spirit upon all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. And on my servants and on my handmaidens I will pour out in those days of my Spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show wonders in heaven above, and signs in the earth beneath, blood and fire and vapor of smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness, and the moon into blood, before that great and notable day of the Lord come. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Tonight is the first of several super moons this summer. Here's a look at the moon over the valley right now. How beautiful is that? The scientific term for the phenomenon is perigee moon. It makes the moon appear larger and brighter.
The supermoon lit up the skies in many places around the world. This one shows it rising over houses in Spain. While this was the view in Las Vegas as the moon was setting towards the western skies of Nevada.
Something else happened this weekend, of course, the super moon. Yeah. A lot of people out last night looking at it, and they saw a little extra something too. It looks like a meteor right in the path of that, the super moon. There you can see it kind of moving off to the side. It almost looks like it splits in two before disintegrating. The American Meteor Society, by the way, reports that they received reports from Texas all the way to Florida.
Brilliant comet arriving in November 2013. It could potentially be 15 times brighter than the moon and visible in broad daylight over the U.S.
Scientists are working to figure out what that big ball of fire was that soared over Northern California tonight, causing a loud boom.
Folks were in awe, some of them in panic.
It was seen from Monterey to Mendocino and east to Sacramento.
Folks walking or driving around were amazed as the streaking fireballs and loud booms were observed over the skies of Northern California.
I looked over, saw like a crescent-shaped object, like reddish-orange in color. But as it went away, it started kind of getting larger, just kind of expanding.
I can't really describe exactly what I seen, but it was something abnormal.
I'm not sure if it was a meteor or not, because a meteor drops right out of the sky. This thing was going sideways across the sky. So to say it was a meteor, I don't believe that.
And if you missed the two blood moons last year, set your clocks now. It is happening again, this time on Saturday, but you won't have a lot of time. You got to be ready for this one. NASA predicts it'll only last 5 minutes, making it the shortest lunar eclipse of the century. Best chances to see the moon turn red, 4:58 in the morning. For more information on how to catch it, head over to abc15.com.
The river that runs through their city had turned blood red.
The other night, folks smelled something strange, and then the Wenju River turned red. Blood red, and nobody knows why.
The riverbanks are covered with garbage. For now, inspectors are taking water samples for closer analysis.
Described as a fire tornado on camera. The extremely rare phenomenon occurred in the outback near Alice Springs.
It's a twister which has sent even weather experts spinning. Flames spiraling 30 meters high, generating noise like a fighter jet.
Outspanned most of the state's coastline, stretching from the border as far north as the tropics. This was Brisbane at sunrise. The skyline is almost completely covered.
Disciples came to Jesus on the Mount of Olives, and they asked him for signs of the end of the age. He said that there would be earthquakes in various places, there would be famines, and there would be pestilences. Of course, we see that there are major earthquakes that are increasing at an alarming rate in the last few years. Earthquakes of great magnitude. Of course, in the earlier years, people say, well, they've always had earthquakes. True, but We are now seeing an increase in major earthquakes, and thus we need to realize that these earthquakes that are shaking the world are a part of the whole prophetic scheme.
Earthquakes with a magnitude of 8.0 or greater on the Richter scale are classified as great by the USGS. These are enormous quakes. And if we chart the frequency of these great quakes during the last 30 years, we note a significant increase. However, due to the relatively short period of accurate tracking, we are not able to establish conclusive trends, but we can say for certain that this generation is witnessing great earthquakes.
When one looks at a geophysical map of the Earth, it appears like planet Earth is a hard-boiled egg that's been dropped on the floor too many times. There are many different plates called tectonic plates that tend to move one alongside of the other. And it's along these areas of movement, the tectonic plate lines, that a major part of the earthquake activity occurs. And it's also interesting to note that it's along these areas where the majority of the world's populations are located. And when we look to the scriptural account in the future, when the Bible tells us that the cities will fall, it's interesting to note that these major cities are located along these tectonic plate lines.
And a growing mystery overseas, scientists are being sent to Siberia to figure out what caused this massive hole to open. It's 260 feet wide. Authorities have ruled out a meteor for now. Melted ice or a natural gas explosion are the leading theories.
That hole is 260 feet wide, and nobody knows exactly how deep that thing is. Look at that. It just goes down and down and down and down, and it's a dark hole.
It's still a mystery as to what caused it.
Even strange. The area of Russia where the crater is said to have formed is ominously called the end of Earth.
Hood being very closely watched because a giant sinkhole is there right now. It actually forced families out of their homes.
Look at these pictures, folks. The sinkhole opened up Saturday evening in the Gulf Coast town of Spring Hill, just north of Tampa. It is already 120 feet wide and 30 feet deep. It has swallowed sidewalks, part of that front yard. Homeowners have never seen anything like this.
Out of nowhere, the earth just went straight up in the air. It exploded up in the air, straight up.
Can you imagine? And one home is closed. The occupants are not allowed back in. It's unsafe. Deputies have spent the night, last couple of nights, watching the sinkhole to make sure it doesn't affect any more home.
Master will be the sign of your coming, and the end of the world, and so forth. And he laid it out for them. And among them was famine and pestilence. And there's an estimated 5 to 20 million people who die of starvation each year. As far as pestilence is concerned, I mean, everybody knows about AIDS. That's an amazing virus that has struck in the last days. We are reading constantly of the tremendous famines that are gripping different areas of the world, and along with those, of course, the viruses, the HIV, and many different viruses that we have not really found yet the answer for. So these are all signs of the soon return of Jesus Christ.
Sight not often seen on the shores of Oahu. Fish by the thousands washing up on the south and west shores. Viewers alerted us of the small dead fish. Beachgoers we talked to say they've never seen such a phenomenon. We wanted to know how rare this is and what could have killed them.
The same type of fish and the same size, dead, on numerous beaches.
Very concerned, you know, because it's an unusual type of occurrence. When I shared the picture with him this morning, he was expressing some concerns too, like, wow, what's going on?
But what are they doing washing up here, and why now?
Something is wrong.
Beginning tonight with some rare and some strange activity around the Monterey Bay.
It's attracted the attention of marine biologists, the locals, and, well, even some lucky tourists.
First we saw like one, you know, and then we saw a little farther on one, and then you go another 50 feet and it was a blanket of dead fish.
That blanket stretched for a quarter mile and was about 5 feet wide in some spots.
It looks like a factory has dumped all of its fish. Never seen anything like it.
These are exactly the kinds of things that Jesus talked about, the warning signs which would indicate that the time of his return was soon.
Several prophetic references are made that imply an increase in chaotic weather in the last days. Jesus said, "For in those days there will be tribulation, such as has not been since the beginning of creation." And the Apostle Paul writes that the whole creation groans and labors with birth pangs, eagerly awaiting the redemption. Just as a woman's birth pangs increase in frequency and strength as the time of delivery draws near, so too, the Bible tells us, the creation will groan and labor with increased frequency.
Matt, there in the suburb of Revere this morning.
That's heading this way, isn't it?
Slicing across Colorado, swirling with dirt, three reported tornadoes just outside Denver.
A tornado has been sighted at the airport.
People inside Denver's airport running for cover. In Nevada, water became the enemy. Flash flooding dropping more than 2 inches per hour in spots, filling the streets with debris and black mud from a burn scar. Just outside Boston, Massachusetts, a powerful EF2 tornado, winds up to 120 miles per hour.
Oh my God, look at those trees.
This, the view outside Revere High School.
They all broke! Look at the trees! They all broke!
Flipping cars, littering streets with chunks of buildings.
It was just unbelievable, like, in Massachusetts, this happening.
It is the first tornado ever confirmed in that county.
Sea ice the size of Canada and Alaska combined has been lost. That's according to the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. An animation released by the U.S. agency shows the daily average sea ice between 1979 and 2012.
Now, a man is close. The disciples came to him privately, saying, "Tell us, when will these things happen, and what will be the sign of your coming and the end of the age?" And Jesus answered and said to them, "See to it that no one misleads you, for many will come in my name, saying, 'I am the Christ,' and will mislead many. You will be hearing of wars and rumors of wars. See that you are not frightened, for those things must take place."
Many will come in my name. They're not going to call themselves Buddha. They're not going to call themselves Confucius. They're going to call themselves the Christ. That was pretty audacious. And yet we've got all kinds of people today who claim to be Jesus Christ.
I'm God.
You people that interviewed this gentleman today, I don't think you knew who you interviewed, but you interviewed God.
Their lives cut short by a madman claiming to be God, the reincarnation of Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ was a great master, like our master is today. The Word made flesh, as the Bible puts it.
Jesus himself warned us that in the last days many would come claiming to be Christ and Messiah. The landscape today is literally crawling with individuals claiming to be Christ, and the Eastern gurus are right on the top of the list.
We have seen so many people today who are making claims to being the Messiah. The latest being Farrakhan, who has just announced that he is the modern day Messiah. And many are being deceived. Jesus said, "For false messiahs and false prophets will rise. They'll show great signs and wonders and deceive, if possible, even the elect." There are so many today in the New Age movement who are claiming to be the messiahs or claiming to be channeling the wisdom of the messiahs for these days. There is the Shirley MacLaine declaring that she is God. It's an amazing thing to me, again, the lies that men will believe once they've rejected the truth. The words of Christ are being fulfilled before our eyes. These are the signs of the last days. The
Pentagon is making the initial preparations for a cruise missile attack on Syrian government forces. We say initial preparations because such an attack won't happen unless and until the president gives the green light. The attack on the Damascus suburbs, which left hundreds dead this week, is looking more and more like a poison gas was used. The United States warned Syria months ago that using chemical weapons could provoke a U.S. response.
The latest now breaking news story now. Syria says Israeli airstrikes on the outskirts of Damascus will make the whole region more dangerous and vowed to do everything possible to protect its citizens. One official said the destruction of the country's military research facility was a declaration of war. Syria's state media says Israeli rockets targeted a military research center on the outskirts of the capital. Video footage and eyewitness accounts suggest that attacks hit weapons dumps, triggering large explosions that
Gaza. Syria says a number of people were killed and wounded amid widespread destruction.
Israel is preparing at least for something on the ground. If not preparing, it's at least worried about any kind of retaliation. At the opening of the weekly cabinet meeting this morning, the Prime Minister Netanyahu said nothing about the strikes, but he did reiterate that he was committed to the security of Israel.
A lot of attention on the Israeli-Palestinian peace talks, which just got started. And that's important. It's very important. The Palestinians and the Israelis deserve security. They deserve to be able to live in freedom and justice and in cooperation with each other. However, one of the questions is the United States investing too much time in that process where there is very few people who think that a deal can be struck in the next 9 months, whereas the number one issue in the Middle East is how close Iran is to building nuclear weapons and how close Israel may be to launching a preemptive military strike. Even the chairman of the Joint Chiefs, General Dempsey, is in Israel today because of these rumors that Netanyahu is getting close to launching such strikes.
Even the Apostle John in the book of Revelation writes of noises, thunderings, lightnings, earthquakes, hail and fire during Earth's final days.
Hearing all my dogs barking.
165,000 hits yesterday, and some close calls this week for people who thought they were safe. Watch this outside Denver.
Here comes the hail, I think.
A man standing in his garage with the door open.
Lightning has killed a second person in 2 days, both in the same national park. It is the latest in a series of dangerous strikes, and that's not the only extreme weather we're seeing this weekend.
Electrical storms have gripped Colorado all week. On Friday, they turned deadly.
Have two people killed by lightning on two sequential days is extremely uncommon.
A Delaware County teenager was struck by one of the thousands of lightning strikes this evening. This happened on Ashland Avenue in Glen Olden.
Take a look at this video so you get a better understanding of what the conditions were like here this evening in Delaware County. In fact, we were out driving in this, and there were, as you can see, the skies in this area lit up with countless flashes of lightning.
Tonight in parts of Washington state where several wildfires continue burning out of control, including one that has prompted evacuations and already burned about 100 homes in its path.
This is a ghost town torn apart by the fiercest wildfire officials here have ever seen. Fire itself is only growing. Fueled by whipping winds, soaring temperatures, and bone-dry conditions, the so-called Carlton Complex fire started with lightning and overnight exploded from 28 square miles to nearly 300 square miles. 1,000 households were ordered to evacuate, including the entire town of Pateras. We know at least 100 homes burned. Major highways into the area are still shut down. Thousands are without power and water. And Brian, this is just one of dozens of fires burning in the West right now.
This is a firestorm beyond human imagination, and we need more assets.
In Siberia, yeah, can you believe it? Siberia had to scramble for cover during a surprise hailstorm. The storm blew up suddenly in 100-degree weather, catching bathers completely unprepared. Two deaths are blamed on this storm system.
You know, about signs in the heavens and the sun turning to darkness and the moon to blood. And so as I was looking this, I went to NASA's website because they have 5,000 years of eclipses recorded. Mm-hmm. Because God created everything mathematically, they can do this.
Right.
Well, I noticed that there were four total blood moons or total lunar eclipses in a row in 2014 and 2015. They fell on Passover and the Feast of Tabernacles in 2014, and then again on Passover and Tabernacles in 2015. I was blown away to see these four blood moons falling on the feast days, and I wondered how often does that happen? And I noticed it didn't happen at all in the 1800s, the 1700s, the 1600s. And so I went to the 1900s, and lo and behold, twice there were four blood moons in a row, and guess what years they fell? This is what we talked about, 1967 and 68 when Israel captured Jerusalem. And then right after Israel became a nation in 1948, they happened in 1949 and 1950. And so I thought this is an awesome sign. I mean, in Genesis 1:14, God said he created the sun, the moon, and the stars to send signs. Typically, you only have one total lunar eclipse every few years. But to have four together in 2 years tied to the biblical holidays, that's huge.
Yerushalayim.